good morning to you all. It is Monday the 12th of August 2014. Good to have your company today.
Is it really Monday? I thought today was Tuesday.
It's Monday.
No, there was something happening on Tuesday.
It's Monday.
What was happening? Mm.
Well, the giveaway is the kid with
it's
the fresh haircut.
It's Monday.
Yeah. So yes, you have got a new haircut.
It's Monday.
What's that about?
Huh? Because the boss rang yesterday.
The boss said you had to have a haircut.
What the hell going on with your hair?
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay, so you've obeyed the boss, so we know something's definitely going.
Yeah.
Oh, I know what it is.
What?
It's your birthday.
No.
That is.
Yes, no, it's Monday.
Birthday.
My birthday's tomorrow, Tuesday.
Tuesday. Today is Tuesday. It is your birthday. You are turning the big 4-0.
Oh, Jesus.
Carlos.
Hit me in the guts.
Well, round of applause.
But right now, we're going to give you some of the best Kiwi jokes of all time.
That's a good idea, Carl. Yeah. Very good idea.
Timmy's got one.
What do you call a Jewish person from New Zealand?
I don't know.
Hebrew.
Reynolds, and he says, what's really long, hard and stuffs New Zealanders? Primary school.
Oh, oh come on, Lisa.
That's a good
you
one.
Can't say that.
Welcome.
You can I don't think that. You can say that. Can
yes, you,
you
can.
Just
can you say that? What do you crave?
Well, I'm craving a little bit of pulled pork at the moment.
Well, the good thing is we're going
to... Not easy to say, is it?
No. And I was going to say something I'd
say
regret.
Say it 100 times.
But we are going to be pulling some pork later.
We are.
Because...
We are.
And this, Lisa, is for you.
I have no idea what I would
it's
do.
Good, yeah.
Oh, they do great food there.
I have no idea what I would do with that much sausage. I mean, you'd have to save it for later, wouldn't you? You'd have to.
Would you like to dance, ma'am?
Hey, thanks, Carl.
We just dim the lights a little bit.
I use my shoulders too much, apparently.
Dim the lights a bit, please.
And a kick is good.
Let's bring the lights down a bit, please.
Hello.
Yeah, get a bit closer.
Oh, no one needs to see that.
Because we've been so good. Let's bring back solid gold.
Understood.
Studio jump off now.
How good is that sound? Stuff the environment. Thank you, Stevie. Hey, just on the
You're
subject
welcome.
Of big engines, a new mm-hmm. survey has revealed that top 10 most popular names drivers give to their cars. And coming in at number one, the Beast. Right. Now, apparently women are the most likely to personalise their ride. And this morning we want you to see... I didn't write that.
We should pre-read this stuff, you know.
No, it makes sense.
It does make sense. So,
it's so funny.
Have you ever called your car anything?
Yeah, my last car, because I've got a new car now, my last car was called Catherine Ann. Because the car I had before that was just a little sort of runabout thing, and that was called Katie Car.
Yeah.
That was when the kids were little.
Catherine Ann.
Now it became Catherine Ann because it was like I had a grown-up's car. So I'm devoid of a name. So if anybody would like to name my car, go right ahead.
I would have thought it would have ended in something like Dent. What's the Dent? What's that actress's name? Something Dent.
You're on your own, mate.
Catherine Dent. What about you?
One of the most bizarre sports you'll ever see, a 12-hour race on lawnmowers. Right. But that was from southern England.
I would have thought we'd be pushing our mowers, not riding them soft like.
Yeah, does someone have to follow them with a rake?
Oh, that's yeah.
Cleaning
good.
Up
Empty
the clippings.
The grass.
Yes. That was always good. My job. Behind mum.
Yeah.
We didn't have a mower.
Did the boys do anything?
Nah.
My
brother had other things to do.
We didn't have a mower. Did you have a mower? We had one of those clipper things. Did you have one of those?
We have
no mower.
We didn't have grass.
No.
You didn't even have a mower.
Privileged up bringing Sylvia Jeffries.
Did you pay someone else to mow your lawn?
No, we had those clips. We had the big scissors.
Yeah.
2.5 acres of scissoring. That's why I'm so built.
All right, you can have it today.
A look at today's front pages.
Then Celeb Buzz with Richard Reed. Have you ever cut someone else's grass?
Now, next up, the annual husband calling contest has wrapped up in the US.
Fred!
Now, apparently, Francis is never late when called for dinner or anything else.
What would you be most likely to say to Pete in a husband calling contest?
Pete!
Jesus Christ!
And Carlos, happy birthday.
Oh, thank you, buddy.
Oh, there we go.
Yeah. Channel 9 envelope for Dickie.
Yeah.
Thank you, buddy.
Oh, it's personal, mate. It's something that I knew you'd like.
That's very. We've got the news coming up. We need to see.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Did he autograph it? He didn't autograph
it. Is that a tear?
No, I can do that later.
He's won a Sydney to Hobart. He's won a gold Logie.
Look, he's won the lottery.
He's got a beautiful wife, Cassandra, and three beautiful children.
Man, it looks perfect.
But have a look underneath.
No, underneath.
Look around.
That's a bottle opener.
Get out of town. Shut the back door. It's a bottle opener.
Oh, there you go.
It works.
It'll take a bit of practice to it. There you go. Oh,
congratulations.
Happy birthday, Scotty.
Oh, pleasure.
Absolute legend, mate. Thank you so much.
Carl and Lisa.
There's always goats in your crosses. Does your weather producer have a thing for goats or something? There's always goats.
He doesn't mind a goat, I've got to say, Carl. He knows one or two of these goats from previous experiences up here in the hinterland.
Oh, that's
come on.
That's you ever seen Jerry count goats? One, two, three. Oh, hello. Anyway, that's another story.
Can't say that, Stevie. Can't say that.
Yeah.
Beers. You've got to carry your whole amount of beers to the other finish line over there.
Okay. Are there any rules?
No.
There's no rules. Great. You've just got to get all the cans to the other side.
Easy.
Are we
get
ready?
Yeah.
All right. Yeah.
What are we waiting for?
On your marks. Get
go
set. Go.
Go, go, go.
All right. Benny's off first. He's got five in his hand. Sylvia's going to pass them to him. Carl and Lisa, they've got some kind of trick up their sleeve. Carl's got his clothes off. He's, no, Sylvia, that is, you are not allowed to do that.
No,
no rules. Disqualification.
Yes.
The statement said you had to carry the cans over. Carl and Lisa, coming up.
Oh, you said no rules.
Clarification, you had to carry the cans, not roll them. It's not lawn bowls.
You said no.
Carry the cans, guys.
Like a sprinkler.
Come on, my Olympians, come on over. Sylvia,
I'm going to get
Ben.
US Embassy after this.
Whoever gets their budgie smugglers on first with the least amount of
viewage.
Porto's lost a microphone pack. Oh,
Ben's tripped up. He's got the towel tied up. Ben and Sylvia are good for speed, not so good for technique. Carl, he's done that before. Right, this is not his first time he's put on a pair of budgie smugglers.
He's lost your microphone.
Again, one in, we might be having a winner.
Oh, yeah,
Sylvia! Sylvia's was first. Sylvia's was first.
Carl and Lisa, Sylvia was first through. Close, Sylvia.
Yes, it's us!
We've got...
Yes. 3 points, 2-2.
Okay, this is the decider.
Oh! No.
They miss out. Carl and Lisa take it out on 3 points. Congratulations.
Yeah.
Richard Reed, have you ever thrown a thong?
I've never thrown a thong. But not that I will tell you. Okay, well, we're going to talk about 5 bedrooms, 5 bathrooms, pool, and of course it has a screening room. That's when you've arrived in Hollywood, when you can afford a screening room. $4 million? Yeah, they should throw in a screening room.
I'd love a screening room.
Yeah.
Right, you too. Yeah. I bet Richard Wilkins has a screening room.
Yeah.
He definitely has a screaming one.
Thank you, Richard. Have a lovely day. We'll see you tomorrow. All right, moving on.
No, they love it. They said so.
They
love the attention.
You ladies going up and surrounding them and asking for photos.
Well, I got a feel of one of the best.
What?
Lisa,
hang on.
Classic, Lisa.
No, look, we'll leave it there. Lisa copped a feel. No. We'll leave it there. Thanks for your company this week.
Classic, Lisa.
We'll see you Monday. Good morning, Georgie in DC. What's going on?
Don't go anywhere if you want to cop a feel.
Things never change, Lisa Wilkinson.